All over Europe, climate change is a growing concern. With global sea levels rising between 16 and 20 centimetres since 1900, climate change is undeniably having an effect on oceans, land surfaces, ice caps and weather patterns across the globe. It is well understood that climate change is caused by atmospheric gases such as carbon dioxide and methane. When we look at these trace gases, there is an obvious correlation between human activity and climate change.
What you see here on this graph is the CO2 concentrations of the atmosphere over the last 800,000 years. And you see that these values are going up and down in different phases. You see on the blue lines here are indicating ice ages, and the orange lines here are indicating periods between ice ages or periods where it's much warmer. But you also see that over the last 800,000 years, the value was always below 300 parts per million, and suddenly, since the last century, it goes up very steep towards 400 parts per million or even beyond. And this is what we have today. This is the increase of carbon dioxide drastically increasing over the last 100 years caused by human beings.
In order to tackle climate change, scientists and governments need reliable data to understand how our planet is changing. This can be provided by ESA, which monitors our planet from space. With four EU Copernicus Sentinel missions and four Earth Explorer missions in orbit, ice thickness and coverage, deforestation, soil moisture, sea level and ocean surface temperature, as well as other essential climate variables, can be measured. These satellites have global coverage, revisiting the same region every few days, therefore providing a good understanding of the health and behaviour of our planet and how it's affected by climate change. In turn, this offers decision makers key information for mitigating strategies and policies.
Frequency and consistent observations of our environment are very important if we want to give decision makers the key into their hand on where humankind has to change practices, where we have to be mitigating for encroaching impacts on our environment.
Satellites can show us how the world has changed. Like here in the Camargue, France, where the coastline has retreated more than 200 meters in the last 20 years. In the 1980s, seawalls were constructed here in a failed attempt to stop the rising water. Back then, sea level was rising, but more slowly than it is now. Over the last 5 years, records show that the rise in sea level is accelerating. Soon, part of this delta will be lost to the sea. And what is happening here is happening in many parts of the globe. Worldwide, more than 370 million people live less than 5 meters above sea level. Over 100 megacities such as New York or Tokyo are near the water. All are at risk. Satellite data gives us the facts so that we can prepare ourselves for the rising tide and protect coastline populations. This data is also used in ESA's climate change initiative, where ESA scientists preserve and work with long-term data sets going back to 30 years and more to get an even better understanding of climate change. Thanks to satellites, we have evidence that the planet is in danger. Now it is up to people on Earth to take the necessary measures in time. The key for sustaining life on Earth might come from space.